Hello and welcome to the Slingshot Channel on this beautiful sunny day, one day after Christmas 2015. I wanted to show you some shooting with the new prototype of the compact roller-based slingshot. Let me show you its features. As you see, the bands are running inside of the slingshot so that you can draw it out like this. But it is very compact and the bands are completely running inside of the frame. Also, there is a magazine built in based on a magnet for 4 8mm stainless steel balls. If you want to take one of the balls out, you simply put your finger inside and then you dispense a ball like this. And the next one automatically snaps into place. Loading is pretty easy. It works pretty much like on a pump action or lever action gun. You just put in the ammo and you press and then you fed one in. Here you can see the inside. As you see, if you pull on the weights, on the bands, they stretch inside of the slingshot. And here you can also see the magazine. You can also see that the two bands are separated with a polished steel nail so that the friction is within boundaries. Shooting it works like on any other slingshot. You simply put the ball in the pouch, like this. Then you draw it out to your anchor point. And then you shoot. Lots of power. Now the trick is that you see there's only very little rubber poking out of the frame. And this makes it very compact. Here I used a normal Rambone slingshot with an equally short band set, except that of course in this one there is no additional rubber inside of the frame. But the draw weight is very short. This is about all you get. A short band set like this has two disadvantages. First of all, the power is very limited because of the short acceleration, but also because of the aiming. The longer your line of aiming along the rubber, the more easy it is to aim with the slingshot. Let's look at these babies in action at 1000 frames per second. Here you can clearly see that the short acceleration is a problem. And on this one the acceleration is far longer, so the bullet is probably twice as fast. Will this go in production? Well, maybe. I haven't really decided. It could, of course, be made much thinner because the wood is fairly thick for making it solid. But if I would make this out of aluminum, it would only be about this thick. So, I truly think this has the potential to be a new groundbreaking and compact slingshot for everyday carriage. But even in this prototype version, it is a lot of fun. Anyway, that's it for today. I hope you liked this. Thanks and bye-bye.